Good morning, and welcome to St. Catherine's as we celebrate the 20th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our celebrant for this morning's Mass is Father Matt, and as one family in Christ gathered around God's table, let's now take some time to greet and welcome those around us. Let's stand and sing together our opening song, The Table of Plenty.
Come to the feast of heaven and earth, come to the table of plenty. God will provide for all that we need here at the table of plenty. Oh, come and sit at my table, where saints and sinners are friends. Aware to welcome the lost and lowly to share the cup of my love. Come to the feast of heaven and earth, come to the table of plenty. God will provide for all that we need here at the table of plenty. Oh, come and eat without money, come to drink without price. My feast of gladness will fill your spirit with faith and fullness of life. Come to the feast of heaven and earth, come to the table of plenty. God will provide for all that we need here at the table of plenty.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
It's a great joy to be with you all on this beautiful Sunday morning as we gather together as the people of God. We call to mind our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have really sinned in my thoughts and my words, what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, on earth peace, to people of good will.
We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God. Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, to people of goodwill.
Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill.
For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who have prepared for those who love you good things which no eye can see, fill our hearts, we pray, with the warmth of your love, so that loving you in all things and above all things, we may attain your promises, which surpass every human desire. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. Wisdom has built her house, she has set up her seven columns. She has dressed her meat, mixed her wine. Yes, she has spread her table. She has sent out her maidens. She calls from the heights out over the city, let whoever is simple turn in here. To the one who lacks understanding, she says, come, eat of my food, and drink of the wine I have mixed. Forsake foolishness that you may live. Advance in the way of understanding. The word of the Lord.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord, the goodness of the Lord. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord, the goodness of the Lord.
I will bless the Lord at all times, his praise ever in my mouth. Glory in the Lord forever, and the lowly will hear and be glad.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord, the goodness of the
Glory in the Lord with me. Let us together extol God's name. I sought the Lord who answered me and delivered me from all my fears.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord, the goodness of the Lord.
Look to God that you might be radiant with joy and your faces free from all shame. The Lord hears the suffering souls and saves them from all distress.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord, the goodness of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, watch carefully how you live, not as foolish persons, but as wise, making the most of the opportunity, because the days are evil. Therefore, do not continue in ignorance, but try to understand what is the will of the Lord. Do not get drunk on wine, in which lies debauchery, but be filled with the Spirit, addressing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and playing to the Lord in your hearts, giving thanks always and for everything, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, to God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me and I in him. Hallelujah.
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 The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the crowds, I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. The Jews quarreled among themselves, saying, how can this man give us his flesh to eat? Jesus said to them, amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the one bread that came down from heaven. Unlike your ancestors who ate and still died, whoever eats this bread will live forever. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So yesterday I had the picnic in the park, and it was my first time experiencing doing Mass in the middle of a pouring rainstorm. And Phil can attest that was not always easy, but we did it. And brought to mind hearing stories of, I was privileged to be in seminary with, at the time, he's now since subsequently deceased, but at the time he was the highest ranking military chaplain in U.S. Army history, Father Boyle. And Father Boyle would tell stories about being in Vietnam and saying Mass on a jeep hood in the middle of the jungle. And speaking about Vietnam, you know, there's a story of this Father Town. He was this Catholic priest in southern Vietnam who was dragged by the communists to northern Vietnam and thrown into prison, and he was noted for his Christian example and his witness so much so that the communist spies and others who were sent to try and report on him and would all end up becoming friends with him and being converted, and he was thrown into solitary confinement, and he would have to have the elements of the Mass snuck to him, and he would have his hand as his altar, and he would have the bread and the wine on his hand, and he would have the wine snuck in through a flashlight, and bread snuck to him among his food supplies. And He said this deep, deep encounter with God that he had celebrating Mass right here. And you hear stories today of the Nigerian martyrs who face Boko Haram and have to, who are currently being persecuted for their faith, for celebrating this Mass that we take for granted. The Mass is essential. All this is to say is the Mass is essential to who we are and to what we do. You know, we've been going through John 6 these last few weeks, and it's Jesus' self-reflection on the meaning of the Eucharist. It's Jesus telling, if you want to know what God wants or what God's thinking about the Eucharist, Jesus says, I want you to feed on me. I want you to come to me. I want you to receive me week in and week out. I want to give you life. I want you to remain in me week in and week out to feed on me. God who becomes food. God who feeds us and rescues us. It's part of God's rescue mission of humanity. He's drawing us to himself. And whether we're facing storms, whether we're facing imprisonment, whether we're facing, you know what, this week is just driving me crazy. I was a rough week at work, or it was a rough time in my marriage, or it was a rough time. I want you to come and be fed. You know, one of the beautiful elements of the Mass is the procession of the gifts. Again, we take it for granted. But there's a reason that it doesn't just start on the altar. Just like there's a reason that I don't just start at the altar, I process forward. It's, all of these are symbolic, have a deeper meaning. So when we start with the procession, that's because I'm representing all of you moving from where you are, the doors, the world, being brought to the altar. When the gifts are brought forward, it's what I want, meaning all of us, to give to God that week. What am I offering to Jesus that he might change and transform it on that altar? What am I, how do I want to be fed? Where do I want to meet the Lord? And that's just such a deep and powerful thing, to be fed by God, a God who wants us to feed on him, who wants to have that intimate, intimate thing, that intimate moment. And Jesus, you know, it's interesting contrasting this with the first reading and the gospel, because wisdom says you always hunger for more wisdom. With Jesus, you won't hunger anymore because you've encountered the ultimate thing. You've encountered God himself. There is no further step than Jesus, than the Eucharist, than who we receive at this altar. You can't go any deeper. You can't go any higher than the Eucharist. It's the height and the depth to which we go. And you know, people pass it by all the time. I have a friend who would say, you know, if I gave $100 every Sunday, nobody would miss. If I give them Jesus and people miss. And that's one of the great tragedies of our lives, is people missing out on this essential thing. But what's the essential thing that we need to be fed today? Where do you need to be fed in your heart of hearts? What's the struggle that you're bringing to God this week? Just take a moment and present that to the Lord. We stand and we profess our faith. I believe
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial of the Father, through whom all things remain. Bless my name for our salvation. By the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. But was again on the third day, according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated right hand of the Father. He cometh again in the ways of the angels of heaven and of the dead.
Knowing that Jesus gave his very flesh for the life of the world, we have the confidence to present the needs of the world to the Lord, trusting that we will be heard.
For the church, that we may welcome all God's faithful to receive the living bread, who provides the spiritual nourishment that sustains us on our shared journey to God's kingdom, we pray. For all who hunger spiritually, especially those who struggle to find meaning or value in their lives, that they may find what they need in Christ, we pray. For all military, police, firefighters, and first responders, may they be kept safe from all harm as they serve and protect us, we pray. For students and teachers who are returning to school over the coming days, that they may enjoy the experience of learning as they seek the gifts of wisdom and understanding, we pray. That human life may be treasured at every stage, from conception to natural death, and every point in between, and in every person, no matter their stage in life, we pray. For all of us here, that we may realize the bread of life we have within us, and find in him the sustenance we need, we pray. For all whom we remember today at Mass, especially the Rusevi family, living and deceased, Lena McCarran, we pray. For all the sick, especially Ed Fitzpatrick, Charlene Villarosa, Matt Schmesky, Shirley Rosales, Amanda Rosales, and all those listed in our parish bulletin and book of prayer intentions, we pray. For our dearly departed loved ones, especially Timothy Carl Portal, that they may rest in the peace of Christ, we pray. For all the prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Generous God, you set a banquet for us and advise to partake in its goodness. May we have our fill and share with others what we have as we look to you to satisfy our every need. We ask this through the bread of life, Jesus our Lord.
Taste and see, taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Oh, taste and see, taste and see the goodness. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall always be on my lips. My soul shall glory in the Lord. For he has been so good to me. Taste and see, taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Oh, taste and see, taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Glorify the Lord with me. Together let us all praise his name. I called the Lord and he answered me. From all my troubles he set me free. taste and see, taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Oh, taste and see, taste and see the goodness of the Lord, of the Lord.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive our oblation, O Lord, by which is brought about a glorious exchange, that by offering what you have given, we may merit to receive your very self, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift it up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
And right and just.
It is truly right to give you thanks, truly just to give you glory, Father most holy, for you are the one God, living and true, existing before all ages and abiding for all eternity, dwelling in unapproachable light. Yet you, who alone are good, the source of life, have made all that is, so that you might fill your creatures with blessings and bring joy to many of them by the glory of your light. And so in your presence are countless hosts of angels, who serve you day and night, and gazing upon the glory of your face, glorify you without ceasing. Then we too confess your name in exaltation, giving voice to every creature under heaven as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he, blessed is he, who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest.
We give you praise, Father most holy, for you are great. You have fashioned all your works in wisdom and in love. You formed man in your own image and entrusted the whole world to his care, so that in serving you alone, the Creator, he might have dominion over all creatures. And when through disobedience he had lost your friendship, you did not abandon him to the domain of death, for you came in mercy to the aid of all, so that those who seek might find you. Time and again you offered them covenants, and through the prophets taught them to look forward to salvation. And you so loved the world, Father most holy, that in the fullness of time you sent your only begotten Son to be our Savior. Made incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, he shared our human nature in all things but sin. To the poor he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners freedom, and to the sorrowful of heart, joy. To accomplish your plan, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the dead, he destroyed death and restored life. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose again for us, he sent the Holy Spirit from you, Father, as the first fruits for those who believe, so that bringing to perfection his work in the world, he might sanctify creation to the full. Therefore, Lord, we pray, may the same Holy Spirit graciously sanctify these offerings, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, for the celebration of this great mystery, which he himself left us as an eternal covenant. For when the hour had come to be glorified by you, Father most holy, having loved his own who were in the world,
he loved them to the end. And while they were at supper, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, taking the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, he gave thanks and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we now celebrate the memorial of our redemption, we remember Christ's death and his descent to the realm of the dead. We proclaim his resurrection and ascension to your right hand. As we await his coming in glory, we offer you his body and blood, the sacrifice acceptable to you, which brings salvation to the whole world. Look, O Lord, upon the sacrifice which you yourself have provided for your church, and grant in your loving kindness to all who partake of this one bread and one chalice, and gathered into one body by the Holy Spirit, they may truly become a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your glory. Therefore, Lord, remember now all for whom we offer this sacrifice, especially your servant Francis, our Pope, Blaise, our Bishop, and the whole order of bishops, all the clergy, those who take part in this offering, those gathered here before you, your entire people, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember also those who have died in the peace of your Christ and all the dead, whose faith you alone have known. To all of us, your children, grant a merciful Father, that we may enter into a heavenly inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and with your apostles and saints in your kingdom. There, with the whole of creation, freed from the corruption of sin and death, may we glorify you. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, with the help of your mercy. We may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, am I worthy that you should enter my roof? Only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
In the working on the road, we saw him. In the telling of our own, we saw him. In the burning of our hearts, we saw the Lord. At the meal, he took the bread. And then he blessed it, broke it, oh. offering. In the breaking of the bread, we saw him. Suddenly our eyes were open, and we knew he was alive. Tell them we went to Jerusalem to tell them, and with joy we told them we have seen the Lord. And as we were speaking, there he stood among us, bless us, said to us, now my peace I leave with you. We saw him. Suddenly our eyes were open, and we knew he was alive. But then we became afraid without him. In the darkened room we stayed without him, waiting for the one he said that he would send. Then the Spirit of the Lord came down upon us, filled us, changing us, giving us the strength to stay. We saw him. Suddenly our eyes were open, and we knew he was alive. We ran out into the street to tell them, everyone that we could meet, to tell them God has raised him up and we have seen the Lord. We took bread as he has done, and then we blessed it, broke it, breaking of the bread, we saw him. Suddenly our eyes were open. There within our midst was Jesus, and we knew he was alive. In the breaking of the bread, he is here with us again, and we know he is alive. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah,
let us pray. Made partakers of Christ through these sacraments, we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that conformed to his image on earth, we may merit also to be his co-heirs in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Just a few announcements. Registration is available for religious education. Classes begin Mary's birthday, September 8th. Email or call Sandra Bustamante to register. You can continue to sign up for either breakfast or dinner. I'd love to get to know you and hear your stories of St. Catherine. So sign up for either a breakfast or dinner with me. Those are continuing for a little bit now. Please contact Phil, Kathy. If you're interested in being part of our newly formed sound tech ministry, so that, you know, there's less screeching and wobbling and whatever else going on, so that'll help with that. The Silver Rose Prayer Service is August 21st at 7 p.m. at St. Gerald Church, and please see the bulletin for details about all of these announcements. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Let us break bread together on our knees. Let us break bread together on our knees. When I fall on my knees with my face to the rising sun, oh Lord, have mercy on me. Let us drink wine together on our knees. Let us drink wine together on our knees. When I fall on my knees with my face to the rising sun, oh Lord, have mercy on me. Let us praise God together on our knees. Let us praise God together on our knees. When I fall on my knees with my face to the rising sun, oh Lord, have mercy on me.